Hello everyone. So this is Ankit Shavare. Now we are in the lecture 8, and today we are going to discuss on diode connected MOSFET. For intuition, we need to understand square law equations and hand calculations. From seeing the device, you should be able to figure out whether it is in the triode, saturation or cutoff mode. For saturation, we have seen for NMOS case that VGT gate can be higher than drain potential by threshold, that is based on square law equations, right? Similarly, for PMOS, gate can go lower potential compared to drain by threshold amount. So these things you should remember, right? By this you can figure out the modes of operation of MOSFET. Now what happens if this gate and drain are shorted? In which mode the transistor will operate? In case of NMOS, if you short gate and drain, and vice versa for PMOS as well, what you will see from the saturation condition that VDS if is greater than VGS minus VTHN, since drain potential is the same as gate potential, it implies that VGS will be greater than VGS minus VTHN. This condition is always true, right? So similarly, you can do for the PMOS case, right? There will be VST will be greater than or equal to VSG minus mod of VTP. And again, you will see the same condition it is going, right? So what we are seeing here is, if suppose your gate potential is greater than threshold voltage or VGS is greater than threshold voltage, the transistor will always operate in saturation region. So if suppose we ignore channel length modulation, it follows the square law equation, that is ID is equal to beta n by 2 VGS minus VTHN whole square. Now let us see one circuit. Here we are putting one current source above the MOS transistor. What you will see, since it's an idle current source and the MOS, as it behaves on the VGS, it also behaves like a current source. So this will be two current sources fighting, right? And if suppose two current sources are fighting, then you cannot predict what is the drain potential in that case. So in this case, even though if you can make this idle current source and this VGS in such a way that both are equal, then the circuit will work. But when you see on the process corner variations or you see the process corner variations or temperature variations, what you will see that these two sources are not same, right? And in that case, this drain potential can be anything, right? So these are conditions which are two current sources are fighting, and this is not the valid condition for the transistor to operate. So let us still see this circuit and predict what happens for intuitive understanding, right? So let us see the square law equation. So this is a plot of ID versus VDS. So you can see that this curve is coming up, right? So this is VDS1, VDS2, and correspondingly this ID1 and ID2, and channel length modulation is shown, right? This slope you are seeing, right? So if ID is increasing, then VDS is increasing, right? So if you are pulling, or suppose you have a part of this idle current source, if you are injecting some current to this MOS transistor, what will happen? That ID will increase, right? So correspondingly what you are seeing, that VDS will also increase. Now if you eject from this drain terminal some current, it means what? That this MOS will get lesser current. So in that case, VDS will decrease, and VDS will decrease, and it implies that what? It may go to the linear region. And once the device is in linear region, it implies that there is no amplification. Okay. So one thing, remember that this square law equation is valid for length greater than or equal to 1 micrometer. And for less than 1 micrometer, we need to include this short channel effects, right? So remember that thing. So for understanding, I've shown the same thing. Instead of replacing this current source, I've put a resistor. Now if you are stealing the current, what you will see that this transistor will definitely go to triode after some of level of injection from the transistor. Okay. So this was all from today's lecture. So please remember that if suppose you are changing or you are fluctuating the current that is going into the transistor can leave saturation region. So this was the conclusion of today's lecture. Thank you.
If you like this video and you want us to create more such videos, please don't hesitate to like, share and subscribe to TechDude.